So, James, we're already in the fifth season of Desperate Housewives. Could you tell us a little about what can we expect? Are there many surprises? What is your character going through in this season?
I can't tell you. it's fun, you know. We've added a new character, as we always do, with the mystery. It seems like how the mystery goes is how our season goes. And the years that we haven't been as happy with it creatively, it's usually because the mystery has been, you know, not quite as interesting or captivating, but adding Neil McDonough this year as the main bad guy on the street has really reinvigorated, I think, because he's just really powerful and really creepy. And I do mean in real life. So he's been a lot of fun.
In a way, Desperate Housewives has set a very high bar in terms of writing. Many people think that the writing is outstanding and it has changed the way television is produced. Do you agree with this? And if you can comment on this.
Yeah, I do. I think the fact that, you know, Mark Sherry really changed sort of the face of dramatic television. When we hit the air 5 years ago, you know, there was no Grey's Anatomy and no Lost or Heroes or House or, you know, the procedurals were doing well, the Law and Orders and CSIs, but, you know, it was ABC was all about Who Wants to Be a Millionaire, you know, and The Bachelor. So I think Mark doesn't really get enough credit. And Steve McPherson, you know, those guys had the guts to put the show on when other people turned it down and trust Mark. And it really did give them a springboard to launch shows like Grey's and Lost, Private Practice. So it really made people sort of see the dramatic 1 hour in a different way, or almost really it was a renaissance for it because drama was struggling when we hit the air.
In the past, the leading characters in television were always normally men. In this case, women are the center of the piece.
Thank goodness.
And how does the guy feel within the show, the characters?
You know, I honestly believe that that unique perspective from a female point of view right down to the narration of Mary Alice is why the show is so popular. I think, you know, there's a real lack of that on television. Everything's very male-driven and male-oriented, all the CSIs and Law and Orders and all the cop shows and legal shows. So I think the fact that Mark created a show that was really from a feminine point of view is part of the reason the show's so successful, if not most of it. So we're just, you know, the guys are happy to let the women have the pressure, you know, let them worry about all the paparazzi and let them, you know, carry the load, and we'll come in and work our 2 days a week and go home. But it's, you know, you can't complain about it at all because not only is it fun and effective, but it's, I feel like it's most of the reason that we've done so well.
Would you say there are wisteria lanes all over the world?
It's a fictional. Yeah, I do. I think it's very universal. I think Mark has found a way to take problems that everybody has, family and friendship situations that are really well known to everyone, and then just heighten it, you know, comedically and dramatically. But people can relate to these women. As crazy as some of these storylines are, people still find a way to find themselves in there.
Is there a surprise factor for you as an actor? Do you get to the set knowing
I'm surprised I'm still alive. The surprise factor for me is that Mike Delfino lives. You know, every year I keep opening the script with one eye waiting for, you know, Delfino plunges to his death. So I'm just happy to still be there. But I'm sorry, I interrupted you.
No, that's fine. But when you get to the set, do you know what's going to happen? Or is you get the script by the minute? Or
no offense, writers. But yeah, we get the script by the minute. And it's just a really difficult show to write. It's a very tough tone to get for the writers with the mystery and the comedy. So we do get this stuff pretty last minute, but there's enough time, and we have time. You know, we don't shoot many pages at a time. You come into your trailer in the morning, you might have 6 or 8 pages that day, but they're in little 1 and 2 page chunks, and it's very easy to learn. So the result you can't argue with. But yeah, we don't have a lot of time to study.
So what's Mike's biggest dilemma in this new season?
Well, you know, not being with Susan is very different from Mike. You know, having a new love interest on the street has been a lot of fun. So that's different. That's different for Mike. And also, he's got, you know, a bad guy breathing down his neck. Once again, sort of like season one, trying to get him. So that's been fun.
What makes women and men so different within the show, if you want?
I think you know, the women being the protagonists in our show is very unique. You know, Doug Savant's character is very much driven by Felicity, his wife. You know, Carlos is pretty much driven by Gabby. Delfino is really just existing as a product of the relationship with Susan. So it's kind of nice that the women, that's the biggest difference in our show, is I think the dynamic of power.